Все может получиться.
Sportbets.com – уникальное место для настоящего геймера. Только здесь возможны ставки на киберспортивные события. Ты знаешь толк в самых популярных играх и готов рисковать? Смотри регулярные трансляции и зарабатывай реальные деньги. Sportbets.com – живой азарт и холодный расчет.
Welcome back once again, everyone, to Room on Fire. Hope this has been a good evening for you guys so far. Certainly, we've enjoyed having you, and we want to thank all of you for subscribing and following the channel. It helps us a whole lot. We've had, basically, we have a full evening of just NaVi games. First, it was NaVi versus Penta, and NaVi won that match, although not really too convincingly. Then we had NaVi versus Virtus Pro, and that game they also won, although it took a little bit of time. Virtus Pro almost made a comeback. Now we have NaVi versus Mousesports, and to cap it up, we have NaVi versus Reason. So we just have a whole bunch of NaVi games. And Vendetta, of course, you're here with me. Semler is on a bit of a break this evening, and we're going to be on Mirage again. What does that make you think?
It makes me worried for Mouse.
Yeah, right?
Yeah.
That's what I'm thinking.
Yeah, NaVi, even though their CT side didn't go the way we, I guess, anticipated, I think that was more due to VP being probably the second best team on Mirage in the world.
Yes.
So, yeah, and NaVi still won. I think they were never really sweating during that game. I think they were pretty confident in the fact that they would be able to close it out at a certain point.
Yes.
So, yeah, surprised to see Mirage. Although, I'm kind of looking forward to it because it could potentially lead to quite a few off battles between Alu, or Chris Shaper for that matter, and Guardian. And yep. Who doesn't want to see that?
That is, I think that's going to be the highlight, isn't it? That's what we really want to see. A lot of fun watching, AWP versus AWP kind of battles, especially when you have the kind of craziness that Guardian, Alu, and Chris J put on the table. I guess if I really had to make a leaderboard, I would very likely put Guardian on top of that leaderboard, but I think Chris and Alu are very high up there as well. They can hit some insane shots. I mean, even I think to the extent where someone like Chris or Alu can actually decide a game almost.
Oh, yeah. I think Alu is one of the most underrated players in Europe, and by Europe, the world as well. Yeah. I think he's just that good. And unfortunately, the Finnish teams he's been in, even though they've had very good individual players, they haven't really managed to gel as a team. They haven't been able to get their full potential off paper and into the game. So hopefully he's able to do that with Mousesports, and I think if Mousesports are able to actually get things going, then we're probably going to see Alu making his, stand as one of the best players in the world.
What is right now? What's the Finnish dream team? Is it like Reflex, Alu, Aslak?
Current?
Like people who we've seen in Global Offensive? I'm thinking like Alu, Aslak, Reflex, and who's Lurpus' brother? I forget.
Aslak?
What's that?
Or Nasu. Nasu,
yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
So, and then Natsu maybe is like the, I don't know. That could be, I mean, what I'm saying is, there is enough Finnish talent out there to make a really sick Finnish team, but as you said, maybe personality-wise, they just haven't been able to make it work.
Yeah, I'm not really sure if it's personality-wise either, or if it's just the fact that, you know, some playstyles don't mesh with each other. Maybe something that Alu the way Alu plays and, you know, makes him excel is a way that doesn't fit in with how two other players play at their best. So they have to make, they have to adapt to each other, and it just, the result ends up being none of them really being able to play at their very best.
Yeah, that could be it. You're right. Sometimes that's definitely something we've seen, a guy being a top fragger in one team and then maybe not so much in the other team because the whole dynamic or the whole pace of the team is a little bit different. So there could be a lot of explanations, but it would be cool to see it. Definitely would be cool to see it.
Yeah, I don't think we've seen the last from the finishing at all in terms of, yeah.
Tropley, who's one of our most recent subscribers, and thank you, Tropley, for subscribing, of course, saying it's placed Aslak, Alu, Reet, and Nasu. That would be his top.
Well, then he's cheating because he's not using players we've seen in CSGO. Because Plase hasn't played CSGO. And Reet, yeah, he's playing at Assembly this upcoming weekend, but we haven't really seen how good he is in CSGO. And I played with Reet once in CSGO, and obviously he had 130 hours or something, so he's still not, you know, at a desired level that we expect to see from Reet. But if you take their top level from the days of 1.6 and Source and what have you, then yeah, that'd probably be a pretty sick lineup. Okay, or not even probably, it would be a sick lineup.
That'd be nice. It'd be nice. Sometimes you wish you could try it just to see what would happen. Be nice if there was one top finish team at least. That could be
It would be great if you get all the 1.6 guys and all the guys from Source who were kind of the staples of Finnish CS to come back and play full time. That would be pretty baller. We'd be able to see Konan and again, Angel Dust, Sisu, Ova, Odious, Plase, Ruit, all of those guys duking it out, and then we'd probably have the top 10 of CS teams fluttered with Finnish players.
Yep, I think, who knows? I mean, maybe it'll happen. We have seen, more and more people return from the good old days and started to pick up this game. So maybe it can continue in that trend as the game becomes more and more popular. I mean, obviously we have some pretty good promotional tools coming up soon in the Gfinity League, which is the second to third, and I'm going to be going there. Of course, we have Assembly in Finland, actually, where Semler is going to be going, and then we have Gamescom coming up in the middle of next month, which is going to be, I think, a pretty big beacon to sort of get more and more and more people playing. I think we've seen a huge spike in the player base of Global Offensive every major tournament, so I expect the same will happen next time.
Yeah, and also one of the new things about the ESL tournament is the fact that we're going to have an Asian team in the tournament, and obviously hopefully that'll lead to, you know, more people from Asia maybe hopping off CS Online 2 and going over to CSGO.
Yeah, could be. That would be great. Especially, I hope that Valve are aware that it's really worth investing into the Asian scene, you know, promoting it, but also making it more accessible. I think one of the problems that's always been with Global Offensive and the Asian scene is, at least the Chinese scene, is that a lot of the people that play computer games in China on PC, they do it from LAN centers. And those LAN centers are not big fans of actually paying for the games. So they just play free-to-play games, which kind of makes sense. I mean, imagine how large the population of China is. If you had to, you know, buy enough computers to and all the games as well, and if you really don't have the economy for it, it's just easier to put up computers and then let people play free-to-play games, which is, you know, League of Legends or Crossfire or Dota or something like that, which is not the sole reason, but it's part of the success of some of those games, I think. And why not Counter-Strike? Why not Valve? Give us an answer.
Yeah, it would be great to see the Asian scene. And actually, I'm a bit sad that I don't know Chinese, because, there are quite a few Chinese leagues happening where teams like Tailu and MB Dale are playing. And I would really like to actually cast quite a few of those games. Not necessarily because the level of play might be the greatest thing we've ever seen, but it's just exciting to get new impulses and, I guess, a different take on CS, because we get very familiar with how the European and US teams play, especially the Europeans in our case, because, well, there's basically league games happening every day.
Yeah.
So having the opportunity to cast some of the Asian games, that would be really fun. But unfortunately, don't know Chinese, don't know anything like how to get around, don't know of any community sites. I know that I think it's 5-play or something.
I actually know one of the Chinese casters, so maybe I could see if we could figure out a way to watch some of those games. That could be a lot of fun, I guess.
Wouldn't be pretty fun. I know for a fact that there is increasing viewership for the Chinese CSGO scene. I think it's not that many weeks ago where Tai Lu played versus NB Dale in the finals of the 5-play tournament of some sort, and Alex from the former WNV team and Tai Lu team casted the game, and they had pretty decent viewership actually, and looked like people were enjoying themselves. And I actually caught the last end of that game, and it was a pretty hard fought battle. So the level of play actually looks pretty good.
Well, maybe we'll have to check into that a little bit later. Now, guys, we have the knife round here. NaVi versus Mousesports. Best of one game SLTV Star Series Season 10. You're at Room on Fire, and welcome to the show. I'm Anders. With me is Vendetta, of course. Semler on a bit of a vacation here just today, at least. He's going to be back very soon, don't worry. And this game is going to be a really, really tough one for Mousesports. They're facing up against the best team maybe in the world on this map. They just defeated VODS Pro, and now they're going to try and do the same here to the mix of players that is Mousesports. Again, if you're just joining us, then I hope you guys are going to click the follow button on the channel. I know you guys are going to subscribe as well. The subscriber program helps us out a lot to keep the channel up to date and keep us active and everything else. So we really do appreciate it, and yeah, that's pretty much it. Also, there's a Facebook raffle at the bottom of the page. You guys can go and click, and you can win a Zoe keyboard. We'll be giving that away on Wednesday when we're doing our own Case King of the Hill tournament with Case King, of course, and Alpenfreen and everyone else. So that is going to be a lot of fun. We have already some pretty cool teams on the list, but I'm not going to announce them just yet because that's going to be a surprise for later, I think. But yeah, a lot of good stuff coming up as well. Those are all best of three games, so that's on Wednesday. You pretty much just have to clear your whole Wednesday evening and just get ready for some good Counter-Strike, because we're definitely going to be bringing that home. Now, then, I mean, Mousesports, chance for an upset here. What do you think it is?
Huh, that's a good question. That's a really good question. I think for Mousesports to come out of this live, I think Chris J has to be in Chris J mode, and Alu has to be in Alu mode, to put it that bluntly, and that obscurely, I guess. They just have to come up huge. I think that's the only way they can beat NaVi.
Okay, well, yeah, Chris and Alu, I think, are the two players that are the ones to watch, but I actually think Legier is also has proven in the past that he can be a really, really solid rifler. I think Leggy just is, not sort of super spectacular, but I think when Leggy needs to step it up and hit shots and get kills that he should be getting, I think he's the sort of guy who doesn't hesitate too much, and he actually is a fairly reliable player in that sense. So I think Mousesports have not a good chance, but they have a chance of doing that. I think let's put it like that, right?
Oh, yeah. And again, kind of similar to what Penta, Mousesports are a team that can take pretty much any team the whole nine yards.
Yeah.
So we shouldn't, you know, close them out of this already, but they're definitely, it's going to be an uphill battle for them, and I think everyone has to be firing at full cylinders to take down NaVi.
It's what it's down to. Best of one games are just notoriously unpredictable. Of course, we did have a start, but then Chris J killed himself, so now we're just waiting for the reset before we get into it here. Again, wow, big thanks to everyone who's subscribing. The sub train, I mean, a couple of days ago, we had a crazy sub train. Oh, that was actually yesterday. But so thanks for just continuing to subscribe, guys. It really does make a big difference to us. And yeah, I mean, I guess ultimately, our goal with the channel is why Semler and I created this channel is because we wanted to see how far we could push Counter-Strike. So the more support we get, the more we're going to try and bring back to the table and see if we can't get more and more action going on. That's the idea. Good luck, have fun, has been called, and I think now we are actually officially live here. NaVi, Vendetta here with a kit and a grenade on seized, and everyone else has body armor, so they're looking for the long-ranged fight, I would say.
Yeah, and by the way things are looking right now, they're going to be able to handle this B push from Mousesports pretty handily.
Yeah, they do have a really strong setup for it. Seized inside, missing a couple of shots here. Not really the ideal situation. Trying to reload. The Guardian is going to take down Elu in a grenade. Oh, so that's a headshot as well. Tamsin goes down. Chris finally getting a kill. Another kill coming in here. And it's actually somehow a 2-on-2. Chris is unstoppable. Goes for another one and is going to find the triple kill. And now is Edward alone in a 1-on-2 here. Nuki and Chris left here. And it's going to be Chris all the way. Quad kill. It's not Chris J. Vendetta, it's Christ J. at this point. I think he just saved Mousesports.
Christ J. That's a solid nickname, actually. Yeah, Chris J. goes full Chris J. mode. That's exactly the start Mousesports needed, and at the start, it looked really rough, because Guardian nailed two really solid headshots as Mousesports were trying to take that side, but then Chris J. happened.
Yeah, that was pretty magnificent in the end. It's far from over. NaVi, they've purchased body armor, and they have two deagles as well, and that's pretty cool. Guardian and Edward with one. So can we be treated to a one deek here? If anyone can do it, I think Guardian and Edward are definitely two of the players that might be able to.
But you know Guardian's going to hear the abuse from Freiburg if he doesn't land a one deek.
I trust it. Freiburg is probably one of the hardest trolls we have in the community. Nobody knows it, but it's true enough. Edward gets shot down to about half HP. Oh, and that Starry is going to pick up Tamsin here. Now Mousesports going to be a little bit careful. I understand they're playing safely and they're playing with respect for NaVi, but they really don't want to throw this away way too much here. Seized is going to be going down. Guardian picks up a kill and Edward will fall. So it's back into a 3-on-3, but the bomb is dropped in the middle. And this is kind of a disastrous situation for Mousesports. They need to move right now and really quickly. Guardian going to come up from behind. Chris going to go down and it's going to be now a 2-on-3. 25 seconds left. Zeus in the middle. Prodi going to get caught here as well and they will recover from it, but to be honest, that was really far from a smooth round from Mousesports.
It really was a hectic round from Mousesports. I think that the big issue there was Nuki kind of being stranded on an island all by himself. Just him and Wilson. that was pretty much it. Wilson obviously being the bomb.
Do you think? Yeah, I was going to say, yeah, it could be the bomb. It could be like a hand grenade, you know, drawing a little face on it.
Would be pretty good. Oh, I actually would have liked to rename the bomb to Wilson, so whenever you're caught alone, you can make that reference.
Well, there's a chance. I'm sure Valve are going to add stuff like that in the future. I think grenade skins bomb is going to happen eventually. Oh, wait a minute. Edward's going to be walking right in, but Legia actually walks and shoots. Sorry I interrupted myself then, but I thought maybe Edward could have got that pick off.
Legia's on point, though. So far, good start for Mousesports in this round, and yeah, they're taking it pretty laid-back style going into this round. You can see Alu hanging all the way back in T-spawn, and Seized actually picks up Legia.
Yeah, I think that was something went wrong there. I'm not sure if it was his mouse or something else. He opened chat while shooting. So that's a big mistake, and Seized is going to capitalize. This could cost Mousesports the round. Not the time to screw up. Alu looking for the kill here, missing a couple of shots as well. And Tabson is going to throw a Molotov, but now again, Mousesports in a lot of trouble. And Tabson has to try and clutch this. He's going to go for it, gets the one, but Guardian is right here. He's picked up the Galil as well, and Tabson is looking for him. 30 seconds left. Guardian just has to wait and stay cool, and he's going to be all right. He walks right into Tabson, though. But these rounds are way too close for comfort.
Talk about unfortunate happenings, though. I mean, death by chat. Really, and that could have gone soaring. He's picked up four kills after getting that initial frag on Legia. That's crazy. Well, what if Mousesport loses that round? How bad does Legia feel about that?
Hey, you'll never recover from that. Chris J's picked up an ult, and Guardian is hopping in the middle, and no one is going to challenge him. But Chris is going to see if he can even out the odds here by just walking in. And actually, if he's got the right timing, Zeus is going to go down. It's a good pickoff. Guardian's going to come and peek here, and he takes down Chris, even though Chris was actually already scoped up on that position. Shows you something about how scary Guardian can be.
And now, well, Mousesports are in a pretty decent situation to actually execute on A, because even though Edward's pushing up meta, getting a lot of information from NaVi, the A bomb site is pretty open, and now all of NaVi are rotating towards B?
Except for Guardian, and to be honest, if they don't get the perfect smoke here to block him, Guardian could easily be enough to hold this bomb site. At least get the first kill, and that should be it. Edward here, I think he's maybe misfed his, or, you know, fed his team some misinformation, because they are all rotating out. just leaving the one Slovakian AWPer in the corner here. They're going to walk in, and then an easy shot from Guardian. Second shot as well, right through the smoke. Eventually, he's going to go down to Alu. Now in the middle, Edwards looking here. He has to stay alive and just wait for it. Bomb is going to go down. Alu's going to go down, and Tabson now can't even put the bomb down in a one-on-three, trying to see if he can find Edward, who's just hiding behind this box, and it's not going to work out this time. NaVi, they win the fourth round and make it 3-1.
I have no idea how Guardian saw any of those players.
Just Guardian things, man. I don't know. I really don't.
I guess he has a no smoking policy. that was just ridiculous. I couldn't see any of them, and I had X-ray on, so.
I have a similar feeling very often when this happens, but I mean, the really, really sad thing, I suppose, for Mousesports is that if Chris had been able to pick off Guardian when he came up the stairwell then, that would have been a 2-2 lead, and I think they could have really taken that round and forced an eco, so could have been very different. This time they're charging into the bomb site. Edward's still alive, and Alu's going to jump into the fire and actually doesn't go down. It's a shot from Edward that gets him killed. And, well, Nuki, 1-4 here. If they'd killed Edward and put the bomb down, this would have been a huge round for Mousesports, but as it is, I don't think they got enough out of this armor buy that they've been doing.
I don't think so either, and they're seeing how they didn't get the bomb, and that seems to be what they were banking on. They're not going to be able to buy up. Because with the plant, they could have forced up with AKs. Obviously, you'd like to see an op on either Alu or Chris J, but...
Yeah.
Yeah, I think they would have been content with just buying AKs and trying to break Navi's ever-so-growing economy.
So do you think that was a smart play, going for that force off? I mean, obviously, we know the result now, so we can say they shouldn't have done it, but would you, regardless, I mean, do you think... I'm wondering if it wasn't, like, a little bit too soon doing it? Because, as you said, they're looking for orbs.
Well, I actually don't think it gets that bad of an idea, because if you can break Navi at that point and potentially go up 4-2 and have Navi being on an eco, then you're pretty much secured 5 rounds on the T side after 7 rounds, and that's huge. Seeing how the T side is the less favored side.
Guardian having a field day over here, and I mean, so that brings the question, this next question here, of course. How many rounds do you think Mousesports needs? They got 3. How many do they want in total on this first half?
Well, given how good Navi, or how well Navi played on their T half versus Pro, I'd say Mousesports might need 8 or 9 rounds actually on the T side to have a fighting chance. Unless they're able to pick up the pistol round. But I think for safety, they need at least 8 rounds to have a shot in this game.
Okay, so there's still some distance to go here before this is really happening. See, is this looking right through the top of the smoke over here? Just, you know, that's the smoke bug that everyone is using, so... Don't want to hear any bad words about Seas, so that's just in the game now, apparently, until it gets fixed, of course. Flashes rain in. It's going to be a standard execute towards the A bomb site here, and Mousesports trying to put the bomb down. Tabson not going to come out on top then. He does some damage to Starix, but nowhere near enough. Now they've got Leggy here in the corner. Chris is going to be able to put the bomb down here. They can't really stop it, but they can definitely retake it. Mousesports don't have any more grenades left. Starix and Seuss coming up with big kills, and Alu and Nuki, I see no way that they can hold this.
Did you see that shot from Starix?
No.
He just completely disregarded the wall. Okay. He just couldn't give less of a care about that. So he was standing towards by that, I guess,
the toll
ticket
booth.
Sale booth. Yeah, the toll booth. And basically just like, yeah, just executed the Mousesports player on the other side. And you could see they were running back there, and he was eager to show his teammates what he'd just done.
Okay, nicely done. Yeah, I could see the bullet holes afterwards, so I can guess what happened. That's pretty cool. That's why it's worth knowing those wallbang spots. Now, NaVi are doing something they weren't all too good at doing against VODS Pro, which is moving up pretty aggressively here in the middle. Flashes. Actually, that's a grenade in on Chris, and he's being covered from Guardian in the back here. Guardian missing a shot, and Nuki's actually going to take down Edward, so I don't know. Guardian not the best buddy here in the window right now, but he's going to try and make up for it, getting a kill and turning it into a 3-on-3. But I think Edward, I mean, he's going to be a little bit sad that Guardian couldn't help him out then.
Yeah, but by the same token, Edward should have been able to pick up Nuki as well.
All right.
So I think that's equal blame on both parts.
Plenty of blame to go around.
Yeah.
And you know, when you're playing in a game like this, the most important thing is actually trying to figure out why it's
who's
not your fault.
Goat.
Yeah.
Yeah. Exactly,
why it's somebody else's fault.
Oh yeah. If you're Edward in that case, you're like, oh, I expected you to pick up Nuki, Guardian. Why didn't you do that? I would have gotten the 4 others if you did.
Good grenade down here. Nuki down to 57, so they definitely know where he is. and that's annoying for Nuki, but maybe he can cause a distraction otherwise, because obviously the main push is going to be for the A-bomb side with Chris and Tabson coming in, and we'll have to see if they can step it up here. There's really not a lot of time left, Ven, and actually there's still two Molotovs, and they're both at the A-bomb side. I think this could be a bit of a roast. We could be seeing some crispy German players in a second.
I think they're going to have a really hard time to actually get onto this bomb site.
Yeah, Nuki goes down now. Two people facing them, and Starix is one. They're going to try and get in. At least the bomb plant's going to be very important. Seuss actually can't get the Molotov down in time here. So it's going to be a bomb plant, and now a 2-on-3 defense coming out here. Tabson with a good shot coming in here. Chris still alive. Peeks out and gets the shot as well. Starix in a 1-on-2. What's happening here? Fake with the pistol, and Tabson picks up the triple kill. Sick play from the German player. It's going to put it at 4-4. And NaVi have a lot of money to buy with, but that was a great defense.
Yeah, a great afterplant from Mousesports, but I really don't understand why NaVi let them get onto the bombsite that easily. That was actually really surprising. I was certain that after Nuki went down in mid, that would have been an easy cleanup for NaVi, but they somehow bungled it.
A little bit confusing, definitely. I agree, it looked like they should have had that. Now NaVi have brought up, and even if they lose this round, they can actually still buy, so Mousesports need to win two rounds in a row. If they do that, it's going to be very impressive. That's unlikely, but they've made it into the bomb site here. The bomb is going to go down relatively quickly, I think. Nuki's the one carrying it. Starik's going to go then. This time, there's going to be no wall bang. Legia learned from last time, and that's obviously good news. Bomb down, and it's a 5-on-4. Let's see if they can retake this. Look how far back Seized is holding here. NaVi are really slow at the moment.
Yeah, and Mousesports are really aggressive at this moment, and this is coming back to haunt them.
Yeah, if they could have kicked off Edward, it would have been different. But now Seuss is battling out. Chris J is going to take him down, and Guardian falls, and it does work out for them. But I think you're right. That kind of aggression, you have to hit the shots at least if you're going to go for it. Edward is going to be running away, and it's going to be 5-4 with NaVi still able to buy. Everyone except Seized actually can buy here, but I think they can even drop off Mars for him. Seuss can, I think. So they're going to be all right. It's going to be a full buy for NaVi anyway, and we'll be looking at a 5-4 scoreline. But I think then... You said you wanted them to get 9 or 8 rounds. I think winning this round, that might be what does it for Mousesports.
Yeah, it definitely could be. If they win this round, then we're probably going to see 7-4, barring some crazy pistol action from NaVi.
They're rushing up, but they hurt them. Alu's ready and waiting. Going to take down one. Seuss with a quick return. And Alu can't pick up the return, but Seuss is going to run right into another player. Edward in the back here takes damage. He's going to go down now. It's on Guardian. And if they're smart about this, they don't actually face him. They just put down the bomb and wait and use their grenades, because Guardian can absolutely win this. If they give him even an inch to work with, he's going to wreck them at this point. Molotov in the back here. Nuki, is he going to be able to sit where he is? He will. Grenade does only 5 damage. So now it's a 3-on-2, and Nuki's just shooting through here. Why does he challenge? I really don't know. This is not a smart play from Nuki.
It really isn't. Mouse still has a pretty favorable positioning, though.
Oh, Guardian now. He's going to go for the one flash. Peeks out, misses the shot, and now there's no more time left. Guardian is going to go down. Every rifle is lost, and we're looking at a 6-4 scoreline, and they even survived the bomb explosion then. And now, the CT side, I think they definitely have to eco here, so this could be 7-4. I mean, Vendetta, what are we seeing at this point in time? I really don't know.
A really solid play coming up from Mousesports. It's just that simple. They're really hitting their shots, they're able to smoke out and basically minimize the potential effect from Guardian. I mean, we haven't seen his op come into play in a big way pretty much the entire game.
No, that's obviously huge, but now NaVi is making a good rotation. Chris shooting Guardian through his own teammate, that's how much he wanted the kill. Just don't stand in the way of Chris right now when he's on this kind of fire. Everyone else is here as well, and actually thought this could be a really good round from NaVi just because they were all stacked up in the bomb site and they made a really quick rotation. Edward is going to be able to pick up an easy kill on Legia. There's the one, but that gives his position away, and Tabson won't even hesitate. Going to be a good long-range shot from Seize to take down Chris. Finally, he's put to sleep. No, actually, that was Alu falling. Sorry, Chris is still alive, and he's going to be taking him down. So triple from Chris, 7-4, and now there's enough money for NaVi to buy again, but... NaVi team can't lose this round. They gotta win this upcoming one.
Yeah, this is a huge round for them, and they're in a pretty similar situation to what VP was in the previous game we saw. This could snowball to 11-4 for Mousesports, and that's something I definitely didn't think I'd say.
I really have a hard time believing that. I'm in the back of my mind, I'm waiting for the point in time when Mousesports, oh sorry, when NaVi just switch it into overdrive and start really just winning a lot. I have a feeling that's still gonna happen, but of course right now Mousesports are proving us wrong. Chris J top fragging at 11. Actually Guardian is out doing it by 12, but then we have Alu and Tabson also really doing well. And now they're going to go for the B-bomb site, trying to switch it up, trying to keep NaVi guessing, and it's working. Edward in a great position here. He should be able to get up at least one or two kills and seized in the back. And already a quick rotation coming out. Nuki gets down Edward, and over by benches, seized is actually still alive. Are they coming for him? Yes, they are. Rotation so quick from NaVi, but they're losing their players. Now it's a 2-on-2, and Guardian happens. Great double kill. Alu with the backstab, though, and Guardian's going to turn around for it. Sees it coming. No! 1 second away, and Alu's going to be walking up, and there's time for this. Guardian turns around and gets Alu anyway. Oh, what a sick shot from that Guardian. He just saved that round, I think, for NaVi.
Yeah, that was definitely all on Guardian. And I'm actually surprised that... I can't recall who it was from Mousesports ran from Forest in towards site, but surely he must have been aware of the fact that Guardian was in kitchen.
Yeah,
there's no way he couldn't have known that. So I think that was a bit of a stupid risk to take for Mousesports, because I think they could have bided their time and actually given Alu more, a bigger opportunity to actually make that backstab work.
Now, I'm wondering what's going to happen here. Guardian is down here. Chris is up in the apartments, and he really wants someone to peek, but nobody will. So when he realizes that, is he going to be able to check far enough in to get a kill? There's almost nobody at this B bomb site, and they have Alu over here. Maybe going to be able to make enough noise for this B push to work. They have smokes as well, so they can... Once the bomb goes down, I think Navi's going to have an almost impossible time of retaking this. And look how close Mousesports are. This is a great call. NaVi have misread the situation. Now he's coming back here. Guardian going to pick up one, but all they have to do is use grenades, and Chris will use an AWP instead. That's almost better. And then Alu with the double pickoff. Okay, that's a... big backstab coming out. I'm sorry we missed that, Alu, because that was obviously a lot of work put into that. Chris going to pick off Edward. NaVi will have no money after this. They're almost going to have to double eco, I think. Which they obviously can't do, but...
Yeah, they're going to be in this awful situation where they have to force up at a point where they don't want to buy. And obviously that plays to the favor of Mousesports. But there we saw, you know, making that backstab more effective for Alu.
What are we witnessing? Seuss walks right in here and is going to get taken down by Tabson. No rifle saved, no money, no hope at all. NaVi are in a very deep hole at this point in the game. 8-5, they're going to have to eco. 9-5 is a likely scenario. The question is if we're going to see 10-5. I don't know. This is a little bit worrying.
It's very worrying if you're NaVi. And I assume that Mousesports are pretty okay at the CT side as well, especially when they have two offers like Alu and Chris J, so they can lock down certain parts of the maps entirely.
Yeah, the only thing we can really say here is that I guess NaVi really did have a strong terrorist side themselves. But at this point, NaVi are basically gambling, or not gambling, but they're relying a lot on winning the pistol round, I think. If they lose that, things are not looking so good. Seized, looking for a headshot here. USPS is not the best pistol for it. He's actually going to pick up a kill and goes for a second one. And coming up from behind, Edward will take one kill. So it's back into a 3-on-3. And or close to the side, it's also going to be Guardian. Another kill happens. And Guardian close enough by to maybe take down Nuki. I don't think they realize. And Chris is a little bit too far away. They should wait for each other. Nuki can just hide in this corner. Guardian still alive. Chris is just charging in here. They're not working together right now, Mousesports, but they still pick up the kills. I actually think that was Mousesports misplaying that last 2-on-2 a little bit here.
I think the misplay started even earlier. I don't think Edward should have been able to pick up that second frag. I'm not really sure what Nuki was looking at, but it was definitely not holding the B-ups where they knew Edward was, because he had already picked up one frag earlier, and he was still able to pick up the bomb planner. So... yeah, a lot of close calls for Mousesports, but they make it work in the end, and at this point, they're going to be completely fine with that because money's not an issue for them.
It really isn't. No problem for Mousesports. We're into the 15th round here, and it's all on NaVi to take it, and they have no kit. They don't have head armor on two people. They have one smoke and one HG grenade. If Mousesports get a good early pickoff here and go it into a bombsite, how can NaVi possibly retake it?
That's the big worry for NaVi right now, and they're also... Well, oh...
Yeah, he crept up in the middle, sniping over the smoke, and there's the opening pick that we were talking about. Now, Seuss is doing something very smart here. He's actually walking down. When Alu comes back to look, he's probably not going to be realizing Seuss is here. And this is just seconds away from death, but what? Alu picks up the kill anyway. That looked like it was going to be all Zeus, and now Guardian goes down, walking backwards into Legia. This is a bit of a surprise here. Mousesports is pretty going to finish this half right now. 10-5 on the terrorist side off Mirage. Really impressive play coming out. In the corner here, Chris going to shoot Seized in the back, and Edward is alone in a 1-on-4. This is looking really scary. Legia wanted to take good half, but again, the fat fingers are coming into play, and he's typing up one of his binds.
And there we have it. 10-5. I think it's safe to say that we did not expect this from Mousesports.
Not even a little bit. I would have been pretty excited if Mousesports had finished the first half on 6 rounds. I don't think that would have been enough, but I would have said, well played, Mousesports. That's good. You're playing against NaVi on this map. It's definitely something you can celebrate. 10 rounds is out of this world. And now here comes the hard part, Vendetta. I think if NaVi win this pistol round, there's a chance they can make the full comeback happen. And
yeah,
that would be painful, I think, for Mousesports at this point.
Yeah, it definitely would. And I think, yeah, it's like you say, if they win the pistol, all of a sudden it should be 8-10. And that's not that big of a deficit if you're NaVi, even though you're playing on the less favored side.
Yeah.
That's right. Definitely something you can work with. But up to this point, I think, well, what we pointed out as being one of the bigger things that needed to happen for Mousesport was Chris J going Chris J mode. And he's doing it.
And he did. We'll see if he can continue or if it's going to be Alu maybe time to take over. I mean, Alu's been playing well. He's up to 12, but there's some distance up to Chris at 18. Welcome to the show, everyone. This is NaVi versus Mousesports. Best of one game here at Room on Fire of the SLTV Star Series Season 10. Thanks for joining us. Hope you guys are going to follow and subscribe to the channel. Subscriber program is a big help to us, and we really appreciate all of you. I know we don't always get to read out your names, but it doesn't go unnoticed, and we really do appreciate it. This is going to be B-push coming out here, Ben, and look at the position.
Look at Mousesports. This is so cheeky. I love this for Mousesports, and this is similar to what we've seen Mousesports do in the past on Mirage as well. They play an extremely aggressive CT side, and I love watching this.
Tabson, 1, 2, 3 seconds. He's going to be around the corner, and he's going to spot the first people, shoots them in the back, but now he's actually missing the shot. Tabson picks up one, and not going to be able to redo, but this is still pretty good. A lot of confusion caused here, but now Nuki has to pick up at least one and preferably two kills. He's at 75. He's going to go down. This is falling apart. And Legia is alone in a 1-on-3. And I think it's going to be a couple of nights of restless sleep before Tabson is going to sort of get over that one.
Oh, Tabson. You could have sealed the deal there, I think, for Mousesports. If Mousesports get that pistol round, I think we're at the point of no return.
Yes.
That's heartbreaking to watch, and we always talk about it. It's the frags that you're meant to get that are the hardest to actually land.
Because
he should have easily had 2 frags.
Yeah, and the really sick thing is, I mean, they moved just as he came around the corner. If they'd been standing still, I'm pretty sure he would have got that. But he didn't even have to take it if he had just waited and walked up behind them as they were pushing in. That would have been almost as good, so... Oh, I mean, yeah, I guess we have, you know, 20-20 hindsight and all of that, but that was obviously a really big throwaway and a big shame. And I hope Mousesports aren't going to take it to heart, and especially Tamsin not, because he's been playing well this whole game. So if he can just recover mentally and wait for the 4th round, as you said, it's pretty going to be 10-8 here. But at that point, you know, can Mousesports keep winning? Yeah, with the double up setup, they probably can.
Yeah, and obviously we have 20-20 hindsight, but I think even so, I think anyone can agree with the fact that Tabson should have won that round for Mousesports. I think it is that simple. You can't really point the finger at anyone else.
Edward spots Nuki, and now they have a bit of a mental battle going on here. Nuki's waiting for someone to come and find him. I actually think this is a smart play, because it could be that now you're assuming, or will be assuming eventually, that he's probably moved out, but they're sort of closing in from every angle. They got underpass, they got the B-bomb site covered as well, and Nuki's just standing his ground.
Yeah, patient play. Patience from Nuki right now. And yeah, he might actually survive as well.
He will, which is really, really good. I mean, this is Galil and armor and 1 smoke and 1 grenade. So this is definitely a big difference. Not that they're going to win the round because of the Galil, but yeah, in the right place at the right time, right? That's what it's all about here.
Yeah, and it's money saved as well, and he's able to drop off his C75 to Alu. So $300 saved there as well, and who knows? Maybe Alu comes up big with a couple of CZ frags.
And now we are going to go for an execute straight to the 8 bomb side. A lot more speed here on the terrace side than we normally see from this team. And see if it's going to work or not. Grenade down on Tabson certainly works very well. The rotation is pretty quick for Mousesports, but again, they only have the one Galil here. And actually, Seuss is going to go down to that one. So good job from Nuki. Jumping through the smoke. It's going to be a double kill coming in. One from Starix, one for Guardian. Nuki hoping to get a lucky headshot through, and he does significant damage. But now he's also down to 27 and... Ah, a couple of more kills here if they took down Seized and Edward. Not that they, I think they'd win the round, but it'd be pretty huge if they could. As Alu falling, Nuki is going to go down, so the rest survive for Na'Vi. And we're looking at a 10-8. Now comes the round where Mousesports has to win. I think if Mousesports lose this round, I don't really see Na'Vi giving up. I think they're going to push all the way through, I imagine.
Yeah, and we're going to see the double off setup from Mousesports.
Chris and Alu, and that could be the thing. So this is the big question then here. What's better, having Chris and Alu in one team or having Guardian on the other team?
Oh, and look at this. Again, Mousesports being cheeky with the aggressive play, and I really like this.
Edward making noise as well, so they know he's here. Tabson has a grenade out. I'm not sure why. This is really dangerous. Flashbang goes in. Edward is going to get completely overwhelmed. I think if Edward had gone for the peak when Tabson had that grenade out, that could have been a much more uncomfortable situation. It's a good start. But it's not the end of the road here, at least not in this round.
That isn't, but Mousesports get a ton of information. They remove one of the most dangerous players from Na'Vi as well. So, and now they can go back to, I guess, more standard setup here as we see Alu posting up towards the A bomb site. And Na'Vi are going to have a hard time actually breaking one of these sites, I think.
Yeah, it's going to be up to Guardian, I think. He's going to have to make the opening, and he's actually just back in T-spawn. Now, this position that Nuki has, before he was here, he was right by the A-ramp, and I much prefer that position because of the way Alu's posted up. If they come through, if Alu misses the shot, then it's going to be down to Nuki just peek out and get the kill. He's going to do it anyway here, so it works after all. That's a really smart play from Nuki here. And now, in the connector, it's going to be Tabson peeking out against Seuss, who actually was flashed, but still gets the kill. So it's back into a 2-on-3 now. Na'Vi... maybe they're able to do this anyway. Chris going to pick up the kill and make it 2-on-2, but I think they have the advantage now, Na'Vi. In fact, I'm quite sure they do.
Yeah, Guardian is in a really good... oh, well, actually, Seuss gets caught out. This is going to be hard for Guardian.
1-on-2 here. This is where he's really good, though, with the flicks. One more grenade. Flash actually does work. Are they defusing? Not just yet. They don't even have a kit here. And Guardian, they both miss a shot. He's going to peek up. He takes down the one guy defusing, and that seals the deal. Chris going to have to try and run away from this one. If he can. Guardian, is he going to let him? Yeah, so Chris makes it out of the corner. That was actually a very sick play from Guardian. Instead of going for the guy who's trying to kill him, he goes for the bomb diffuser, and they didn't have a kit, so there was no chance.
Yeah, I actually think the big misplay from Mousesports there is not having Chris J being the guy on the bomb. Sure, it's tempting to have Chris J there, because obviously if he just connects with Guardian, Guardian is dead. Because he has an op, but... I don't know. You kind of give yourself more opportunities to actually get away with that if you have a guy with a Colt aiming up towards Guardian. Because Guardian's just going to do a quick peek either way. There's no way he's going to stand out there and let you get a good shot at him. So just have a Colt constantly kind of frustrating him and putting him in an awkward situation, I think that would have been a lot better for Mousesports than what they opted to do.
Yeah, because then they had basically one chance to do it and they missed it. Nuki and Tabson here, sees at 75's close range. Seuss is going to be walking right out here, but actually Starix will get the first kill. Tabson down in shadows. Chris with the AWP, and actually a good shot coming in here. Chris is down, unfortunately. Guardian is going to fall down, so now it's 2-on-3. Edward and Seuss got to try and stabilize the situation. Legia misses a shot, but this is still kind of doable. Edward walking in, not checking the corner, is going to go down. Leaves Seuss in an awkward position, and now they just need to wait. There's no bomb plant. Alu doesn't have to peek this, but he keeps on doing it, and he dies here. It's going to be a little bit uncomfortable for Tabson, who's now alone. I'm not sure why that was.
Why is Tabson going away? He knew he had the bomb by A-pit. He knew where Alu was, and they both knew where Seuss was.
Tabson in the corner, Seuss right around here. He checks it once. Now Tabson, it's all down to timing again. We've seen this before when it was Edward playing against VODS Pro, and Edward came up with the timing. Seuss, he feels like he's already checked it. He's going to go the one. Tabson is now checking. He doesn't realize he's right underneath him. This is ridiculous. Look how close they are. And Tabson walks out. He's going to spot Seuss and take him down. And Tabson wins the round. Triple kill. What an absolutely ridiculous one-on-one. That's the stupidest thing I've ever seen. 11 to 9.
What the hell was that? That was just a weird round. But yeah, Mousesports are making these rounds so much more scarier for themselves than what they should be.
They really are.
Yeah, I have no idea what tabs... one thing is Alu, obviously, as you pointed out, why was he re-peeking? That makes no sense. As Chris takes out twos, but why was Tabson moving away from everything?
I can't explain it. I think he was hoping that if the bomb went down, he would have been able to surprise him coming out of the apartments. It was like a long con type of you know game where he basically thinking a little bit too far ahead. That's the one thing. But then the other thing is, why was Alu challenging that much?
Yeah. Now I thought Alu was challenging basically to buy time for Tabson to come up from the pit and get an easy pickoff. I thought that was the initial idea, but apparently the two mouse players had two different ideas. But right now though, look at Nuki. Oh, Mousesports are fully aware of this.
And Leggy is going to finish it off here. So it's a really good shot from Chris. He actually tags him right at the edge there. Now they spot a Guardian as well. He's going to go down. This is a flawless round, so this is a really big deal. Not only did Na'Vi not get the bomb plant last round or this round, they don't get any kills this round. They're still going to bomb plant, as I said. They have no money, and Mousesports starting to actually build up an economy here. So it's a 3-round difference, and it's probably going to be a 4-round difference. In spite of the mistakes here, do you think Mousesports are going to be able to close this game?
Well, as of right now, it looks really promising for them. And with Chris J being in form as he is now, who knows? They're very likely to take this actually at this point.
Well, Sue's coming out of apps. Not going to be able to make it work. He does actually pretty good damage to Nuki here. Nuki, whose rifle is called Yes, This Is Dog, which I'm assuming is because of the wolf on the rifle. Somehow that actually is very funny. I don't know why. Seized. Going to be down to 20 HP. Obviously, this eco round from Na'Vi isn't really going anywhere as they're missing a lot of the kills they maybe could have had. I mean, Alu, Tamsin, and Nuki could have maybe gone down, but now it's just on Seized to find peaceful rest here in the corner, and he's gonna find it. Look, that is very peaceful right there. Basically the most relaxed position you could find without a chair.
Yeah, and you know, under the sunroof as well.
Exactly. So there it is. He's put to rest in a nice way now. He's ready for this upcoming round, and let's see. I mean, Na'Vi, come on, it's Na'Vi on Mirage.
Na'Vi
they
snap.
Should be able to do exactly. We can just rename this DE Na'Vi and it'll be fitting. 9-13 is the scoreline. Mousesports have a lot of money right now. They can lose this run and the next one and maybe even one more. And they're going for more aggressiveness. Flashbang in. No flashbang. They just walk straight in. And Nuki will pick up another one. Complete devastation. Na'Vi getting wrecked right now. And it's going to be a miss coming out here. Seuss walking around. Tabson will pick up a kill. And he's going to pick up one more here, Seuss, before he goes down. 14-9. And now, once again, no more money for Na'Vi. But it's going to be a match and map point if they eco now.
Yeah. And I think Na'Vi has to play for tie. Yeah, and it seems like that... No, actually, a bit of a late back... Oh, actually, what? So, some of them opt to buy up. This is weird. Three players commit to a buy from Na'Vi. Seized and Starks do not. Or Seized actually picks up armor, but yeah. This is odd.
Odd and... I don't know, very... Yeah, I can't really explain what's happening right here. This is really a strange situation for the Na'Vi team, I agree. Tabson, gonna take down Seized. They will have such a weird vibe for the last round here. I mean, Guardian with a good jump over there, gonna pick up the one kill. And Seuss is also doing damage, but they're in a 4-on-3, and they don't even have a bombsite right now. Edward will have to come up big coming through the connector. If he can pick up two kills here, maybe something can happen, but otherwise, I'm just not seeing it, and they are counting on it. And Chris, I mean... He saw that coming miles away, all the way from the Netherlands. He saw that kill or that walk up there from Edward, and that's going to be it. 15-9, and they have money, but they have a weird distribution going on.
A really weird distribution. I assume Starks is going to drop an AWP for Guardian.
Yeah. Yeah.
Or actually, no, he didn't. No, he dropped an AK, and Guardian went full glass cannon.
I'm not sure I can explain it. Good pickup from Edward. Is it going to be the comeback? Tabson says, hell no, not on my watch. Takes down Starix and Seuss. And now Seized, Edward and Guardian are left here. They're fighting to stay in this map and force the draw, in fact. But Nuki with a good headshot. Seized, headshots, taps, and not enough. He runs around, gets the kill. Now a 2-on-3. Guardian and Seized. Two of the best players on Na'Vi left here. Can they do something about it? Legia spots one person and just falls back. That's definitely a smart play right now. Mousesports don't need to challenge, but they will trade one for one in the middle. Nuki for Guardian, and Chris stays alive, and now it's Seized. What do you think? I mean, and that's where I'm shocked. Can he do this?
If Chris gets into position, I don't see any way Seized can do this unless he goes into jungle and somehow ends up behind Legia.
Chris has 27 kills, and I think Seized is about to be the 28th. If Chris walks back around, the timing is going to be beyond godlike, and my god, it is. Seized goes down. 28 kills. Christ J has been born as an official term right here. 16-9 is what we're looking at, and Mousesports take the victory over Na'Vi on Na'Vi's absolute best map. What a shocking result here for the SLTV Starseries. That is going to take some time to digest, I think. That's the wrong overlay. This is the right overlay. I am shocked and a little bit worried as well. Guys, we have another match coming up for you. It's not over yet. The next one is going to be Na'Vi versus Reason Gaming. Another best of one coming up here, SLTV Starseries. But do not go anywhere. We'll be right back. It's going to be a quick break of about 5 minutes. No more than that, and then we'll be ready. So stay tuned and don't go anywhere. Invite your friends and follow and subscribe to the channel. What a day it's been. Just nothing but strange upsets. But we will be back in a sec.